How's everybody doing? Thank you so much for coming tonight. Welcome to Five Mics. I'm personally very excited. I think these guys are pretty excited too. This is the first one of, the second season of Five Mics. We did five of them last winter, and they were all very interesting and very emotional and exciting at the same time. A little bit of insight on what this event is and what you could expect. As a performer, the inspiration to try to create an event like this, it really comes from, as a songwriter, it comes from really yearning for a listening room audience and having, you know, people that are here to experience and engage and interact and ask questions. So I'll start, just Fate. This first song I'm gonna play, it's called Borrowed Time. The instrumentation to this song I've had for a very long time, probably about 10 or 12 years at this point. And it was always an instrumental that I would just kind of play to myself and never really made it in any bands per se. And then I co-write sometimes with a good friend of mine who lives in Nashville, his name is Brother Country. And he sent me this poem one day and I was reading it and it just resonated so much with the feelings I had behind this instrumental, which at the time I was living in Arizona and I had a lot of alone time and things seemed kind of difficult for a while. And I felt like I was just like reaching out in different ways, like reaching up to the sun to like borrow like the sun by, oh, thank you for shining today. Like I'm so happy that it's a sunny day. Just things to make me feel better. And then my friend sent this poem over. And it was titled Borrowed Time, and him and I kind of poked at it a little bit to make it fit. And
so the instrumental section still exists in there. I'll go ahead and play. Thank you.
that's going to decide the next player, and so forth and so forth. So the first round gets established live in front of you and creates for banter.
Dramatic tension.
Can we get a feed drum roll? All right, next up, Ms. Ray Kimura.
I'm Ray Kimura. And this song is called Go Getter. I play with one of my bands in Brad Room. One night I came home, I was sitting in my living room with a close friend and my mom, and I just had a guitar around me and I just came up with this riff, and then all of a sudden these lyrics started coming to me. So I hope you guys like it.
From the Republic of Georgia, where I spent some time studying the music there.
basically like a Georgian ukulele, traditional Georgian ukulele. And I brought a death song, a birth song, and a rebirth song tonight. So I'm going to start with the death song. And wrote it a long time ago. It's about the death of a relationship. And it's called The End of the Song. And I need a little audience participation percussion help with it. Are you guys willing? Yeah? So I'm going to do a little slow thing at the beginning. And then when the pandori starts, if you can give me a...
enjoy sharing this instrument, and he gifted it to me at that time, So it never leaves the house. And this is the this is only the second time I've ever performed net live. Extremely valuable for me emotionally, as well as being the best-sounding instrument I've ever owned. So this song I wrote, it's a relationship song. I grew up in a rather volatile household, and I think when you do that, you tend to gravitate toward folks that might have grown up with similar experiences, and you can kind of see their fire, both the bright side and the volatile side of fire. And so that image was kind of stuck with me, and I wanted to write a song about that relationship idea and how we might do that in somewhat self-destructive ways, but that also fill your life with colorful, wonderful experiences that can also not exactly end in what was once beautiful. So this is about a relationship. The protagonist or character, the male of the relationship, is named J. William Hope, kind of named after my great-grandfather, who was J. William Flood. And I grew up on Hope Street, so I incorporated that into this character's name. And that character, you know, saw this fiery woman across the bar one time, and he knew he had to embark upon connecting with that person due to the fire he saw in her. And there was something about that relationship that I think they both characters knew that it was ultimately kind of doomed, but they couldn't help but explore it.
Kill you with a keen eye. was living on a cottage out of a farm in Dumerson, and my roommate had gone away, and he asked me if I could water his garden patches, and the guitar part actually sort of like popped into my head while I was doing that, but such as the song is just kind of a reminder of myself and to learn from my mistakes and keep faith on that, so it's called Won't Be Broken.
Steve, that's a good, it's a good question, asking about pain in songwriting. I think I'm incapable of writing a song that's super happy and bubbly. I just can't do it. I love my wife so much, and my wife is like, "When are you gonna write me a song? You gotta hurt me." So that's just my way of getting out of writing a song. So this next song is it's about hard times and not so much pain, but more confusion. It can be pretty raw in my mind. Like my wife and I, we have three lovely children, and this song, the lyrics to this song, came when we found out that we were gonna have a kid. And so, you know, so many emotions going on, so much conversation with Aaron and I about everything across the board, and kind of referencing what Steve was asking, the lyrics of this song, they can be interpreted as kind of like messed up, like it's kind of messed up, maybe it might sound insensitive, but it was a way for me to let out certain emotions and ideas, to just let it flow, let it go, and not really attach myself to it, but, you know, turn it into a song. It's called Big Things. And it's about how I felt when I found out I was getting my first kid.
How many do you have now?
3.
17.
Our oldest is going to be 12 in a few weeks, and Pearl's 6. Thank you.
next one is called the River Song. And I really wrote it for like a full band piece, so it might sound a little bit empty, because I usually play with my whole band. But I wrote it about a year ago, last December, when I was talking to my mom, and she brought up that at Bennington College there was a Muslim exchange student who was missing, and that they found her car near a quarry and stuff, and that people were searching for her and they couldn't find her, and people were very worried, and it was very unlike her to like not be heard from it for a matter of days. And everybody was kind of sharing around her blog. She like wrote a lot of posts and stuff, and she did a lot of art. She was a dancer. And I was reading some of her poetry and some of her writing, and a couple months before this, in September, she was like, "Today was my 22nd birthday, and I'm so excited for this year. I can tell it's going to be a great one." And then she went missing. And later they found that she had committed suicide. They found like a journal or something, and it was like a goodbye note. And I was really moved by this. I mean, especially after the election last year, a lot of people in this community especially, and all over the nation, were very upset. And like suicide hotlines immediately went up. I went to school the day after the election, and there were eighth graders crying, and you know, everybody was very upset, no matter what age, no matter who you were. So I was really moved by this, and especially since she was a Muslim, I know that a lot of some of the leaders today have some ideas and stereotypes about Muslims and discrimination against them. So I have a lyric in the song that's too cold for a flower to grow here, but love is near. So it's kind of referring to like, not only was the climate cold in Bradford, Vermont in December, but you know, the political climate as well, being kind of not opening towards all people. And the girl, her writing and everything about her was just very beautiful. And the fact that she felt like she couldn't, that she didn't have a place in this society was kind of heartbreaking for me. So too cold for a flower, her to grow here, but love is near.